One of the three factors for controlling your exposure is the aperture. The aperture is a small hole inside the lens, and you can change it to make it larger and let more light in, or smaller to let less light in. The aperture works a lot like your pupil. When there's a lot of light, that hole gets smaller. As soon as that sun goes down, my eye is going to dilate to let more light in. The bigger the number, the smaller the hole. So an aperture like f/22 is a very small hole, and a number like 2.8 gives you a very large hole. There's also a secondary effect of the aperture, which controls something called the depth of field. The depth of field is how much of your image is in focus. If you use a small aperture, a number like f/22 or f/16, you're going to have a greater depth of field, which means more of your image is in focus. If you use a wide open aperture, a lens such as a 2.8 or 2.0, then you have a very small depth of field. Most zoom lenses, like the Tamron 18-270, are what's called variable aperture lenses. That means the widest aperture changes as you zoom. There are also lenses like the 17-50 2.8 Tamron, which are constant 2.8 lenses. It's a common misconception that if someone says a constant aperture lens, it means that you can't change the aperture. Lies. Lenses that are 2.8 lenses generally let more light in and are very effective for stopping action or taking pictures under low light situations.